And you're watching the Mixture of Experts series here with NYSE Wired plus theCUBE. And I'm excited to say that Kevin Tian is here. He's a co-founder and CEO of Doppel. Really interesting, I guess, security startup, but with a little different twist. Welcome to theCUBE, good seeing you.
Thank you for having me, Dave. Really excited to be here.
Yeah, you bet. Okay, so you're a co-founder and CEO. Why'd you start the company?
So the company started, you know, really before all this. Actually, I was a software engineer at Uber and Lyft. Met my co-founder Rahul there, and we started the company in 2022. This was right before ChatGPT came out, and you know, we knew that AI was about to blow up because he was roommates with the head of research at OpenAI. So. For us, we started the company.
Get out of here, that's awesome.
No, it's crazy, right? The stories that we get to hear. But you know, for us, it really was about the opportunity to solve the greatest threats with AI. And with Doppel, we're doing that by solving all things social engineering.
So you knew that the AI herd around the world was going to be big.
Exactly.
Did you know it was going to be this big?
It's a good question. I mean, we knew it was going to be big, like just the stuff that was coming out, the stuff that we were hearing about in rumors, right, in Silicon Valley, and, you know, of course, you know, it's hard to predict exactly how that plays out, but we knew that this was different, right, than just the traditional machine learning and traditional AI from the 2010s.
Yeah, so, okay, so you're described as an AI-native digital risk protection platform, but you shared with me a little sort of new messaging, which is social engineering defense.
Yep.
Explain that. Where were you in 2016 at the election?
Great question. Well, look, you know, the premise of Doppel, right, is, you know, especially we're seeing a lot with Scattered Spider today, right, where if I'm a threat actor like Scattered Spider, some other cyber criminal trying to get into your organization, with AI, there's more channels than ever before. I'm not just doing a phishing email now. I'm sending you SMS campaigns with AI. I'm doing deep fake voice calls. I'm running fake personas on LinkedIn, pretending to be part of your company, things like that. And so for us, we view this as much more than just digital risk, brand, or executive protection. It's really all things that touch the human layer.
Yeah, so that's your why. I mean, the risks are exploding.
Exactly.
And you need a new approach.
100%.
Because AI has essentially rendered our ability to combat conventional phishing nearly useless, because humans used to be able to handle that, you know, that 1% that would get through.
Right.
Don't ever click on links if you don't know where they come from, but I know they do, but notwithstanding bad user behavior, humans could generally keep up, no more with AI. And so the threat vectors are multiplied by 10 or 100x. That's where you guys come in.
Exactly. I mean, just look at, you know, the past 18, 24 months, right, with AI and how, you know, if you look at how companies have been breached today, right, it really is the fact that it's not just the email anymore, but it's multi-touch campaigns, it's multi-channel campaigns. So what we talk about at Doppel all the time is how do we do two things, right? How do we, one, use a multi-channel threat graph to combat this, right? Anytime we see a particular email or a phone number, how do we actually tie it to the whole threat actor infrastructure? And then second, how do we use AI itself to combat AI, right? Just because if these bad guys can spin up these attacks for just a few cents, right, we got to make sure that you can run the analysis, run the response playbooks, and do the takedowns of that infrastructure, which is something special that we do at Doppel. Make sure that that also scales from a unit economics perspective.
So Kevin, part of your IP is you've created a knowledge graph, graph database, if you will. That's your IP, is that right?
Or? That's correct, yep.
Okay, so tell us more about your whatever you can share about your secret sauce, we kind of get your superpowers, but how are you actually able to achieve that technically and architecturally? What are the differentiators?
Yeah, I mean, the key thing is we collect data that no other security company collects, right? We're not just collecting the traditional dark web data and domain data and phishing email data, but we will collect the fake telephone numbers pretending to be Dave. We'll collect the fake LinkedIn accounts of folks, you know, pretending to be part of Doppel or, you know, whatever organization. We'll collect the Telegram accounts, WhatsApps, the paid advertisements, things like that. And so because we've got more pivot points, that's how we can then map out threat actor infrastructure with our graph-based architecture that other folks can't.
So, I mean, don't the big threat intel companies, whether it's, you know, Palo or a CrowdStrike or a Mandiant, aren't they're not collecting this type of data? Is because they're trying to solve a different problem?
Exactly. So I think a lot of traditional threat intel, right, focus on the traditional network security model, right, where we're collecting IP addresses, we're collecting domains, we're collecting URLs. But rarely do we see folks collecting, you know, WhatsApp accounts, right? Rarely do we see folks collecting a Google advertiser ID or, you know, maybe a Telegram page, right? And that's where we've seen the evolution of threat actor tactics. And just because you're not covering it doesn't mean the threat actors won't be taking advantage of it.
You know what's fascinating about that, Kevin, is that, I mean, we know that, I don't know what the number is, but a preponderance of the stolen credentials are from phishing.
Right.
And so, and there are companies, of course, that focus on just that space.
Right.
But the big, you know, multi-hundred billion dollar market cap companies, you know, generally don't. It's more, you know, responding and
right.
XDR and so forth. But that's the number one problem. And you
right.
guys, so when you're doing your business plan, you, I mean, it seems obvious, but
right.
maybe that was the obvious, you know, epiphany.
For sure. I mean, look, there's no 800-pound gorilla yet for all things social engineering, right? And, you know, CrowdStrike, of course, great on what they're doing with endpoint, Palo Alto Networks great about what they're doing with firewall. So for us, from a business plan perspective, this is the, you know, great opportunity for Doppel.
You know, you say that, but I'll tell you, there's no real 800-pound gorilla in security. I mean, Microsoft is probably the closest
mm-hmm.
at maybe a $20 billion business
right.
and a lot of hair
right.
on that dog. Yeah, you got CrowdStrike and Palo Alto, big valuations, but even like Palo Alto, probably the next largest, I bet you they have less than 10% market share.
Right.
You know, so it's a really wide open and fragmented business. So I guess my question is, how do you deal with, okay, here's another shiny new toy
right.
that is going to add to the number of vendors in the security stack
right.
And increase complexity? How do you respond to that?
Well, you know, the good news is that we're often actually simplifying security stacks for our clients, right? Helping them consolidate, you know, multiple vendors, right? For example, maybe they had a siloed dark web solution, maybe they had a siloed social media solution, maybe they had an email solution, right? But with the graph-based architecture, the whole value prop is that if you put that in one data lake, that's how you can then map out a whole bunch of threat actor activity that you couldn't before. So I think that's one, you know, value prop pitch, and then, you know, otherwise, you know, execution is key, right? In terms of the business results you can show, the risk reduction you can show, that's always important.
Can you do a little like AI 101? We should all be experts in AI by now, but like what are the techniques that you're using? You know, deep learning, machine learning,
yeah.
generative AI, you know, agentic is now, obviously
right.
you're using agents. Can take us through kind of the basics.
For sure, I mean, well, I think the, you know, you've got traditional ML, which has always existed in the 2010s. You've got, you know, new AI techniques developing with deep learning, right? Especially with self-driving, things like that. To us, really the big breakthrough with 2022 was the LLM, right? And then the agentic work behind it. And so, look, I know a lot of security vendors claim they use AI, and they certainly do in some way. But the stuff that we found most exciting at Doppel, and, you know, specifically with our special relationship with OpenAI, right, is how the reinforcement learning loops are being developed with these agents. So, you know, there's stuff that we do that no other security company in the world does with AI in particular, and, you know, basically gotten access to APIs that are still in beta, right, things like that, and that's where we've been able to uncover a lot of, you know, efficiency gains with AI.
What is your relationship with OpenAI?
So we work closely with them. We've done case studies with them around, you know, how do we deploy agents at scale in production. You know, what's great about Doppel is that we're full end-to-end service. So, you know, when we deploy agentic AI, we also have the humans in the loop to correct it. We have the tier two, tier three analysts where, you know, just like a self-driving car, right, it might need some interventions. So, and so, you know, from what we've seen, right, our use case is perfect for agentic AI because we're facing high volume of alerts every single day, hundreds of millions. It doesn't require deep context into internal systems to figure out, hey, this is a fake Dave. And that's exactly what we're doing with AI agents is we've actually been able to automate away entire security operations teams within Doppel.
So I want to come back to the volume
yeah.
because it's pretty impressive and your accuracy level. But given that reinforcement learning is such a critical part of quality AI, how are you feeling about the scale AI deal
right.
with the whole Meta thing? I know there are alternatives out there. By the way, we just had some folks on last week that
yeah.
whose business is going through the roof now.
Exactly.
Because they have, they're quite capable, but how will that affect your business, if at all?
Yeah, well, I think it's just validation of the approach, right? Like, the big AI opportunities today is how do you, you know, not just do AI as a co-pilot, but how do you actually totally automate the end-to-end? And in order to get there, you know, we started very similar to scale, right? Like we today still have teams in Philippines, we still have teams in India, we still have teams in the US, right? We have a 24/7, 365 SOC. But the way you get to full automation, right, is you need that feedback loop with those teams. And so, you know, in our view, it's validation of that approach where, you know, the real opportunity with AI is how do you take something and automate it end to end and own that end to end workflow.
So over 100 million alerts daily. So these teams all over the world, I'm presuming they're not wearing beepers, achieving 90% accuracy in identifying genuine threats. So
right.
you're eliminating a lot of false positives.
Correct.
And then the human in the loop is both to increase that efficacy and to address the other sort of 10%?
Exactly. I mean, I think, you know, being someone new to security and coming in, it's been interesting to see how precision and recall is always the, you know, battle, right, in security. How do you get your system more and more accurate and reduce false positives, but how do you also make sure you don't sacrifice on recall, right, and miss something important? And so, you know, what we found quickly, for example, with our AI agents, they actually started becoming better at recall than the humans from a numbers perspective. Like, we're actually now at the point of 99% plus on recall. So then it was precision became the problem for the humans to solve. So, but yes, you know, basically our goal with the humans, right, is whatever is the key gaps right now with the AI, whether it's a precision use case, whether it's a recall use case, that's the focus for the team.
Voice fakes are scary.
Yes.
How good are they? How can we best combat them?
They're really good, right, in the sense that we've seen them actually successfully breach people or at least cause, you know, significant financial loss to some big companies in the world, right? Best way to combat it, right, I mean, it's, you gotta throw everything at it, right? And so, you know, our approach at Doppel is, again, it's that multi-channel piece where if we know about a voice call that's happening, we're immediately linking it to, you know, is there also an email going out? Is there also, you know, is this person even real? Is this a fake business? Things like that. So how do we collect that data? And then also we're actually developing new capabilities on the simulation and awareness side as well. So, you know, because we see these campaigns, how do we help you prepare for them?
So the company you've raised, am I correct? Almost, about 59 million, right?
54.4, 54? Yep.
Okay. And through Series B, is that correct?
So we just announced our Series B with Bessemer, yep.
All right, congratulations, awesome. So where do you want to take the company? I mean, look out 4 or 5 years, where do you want to be?
Yeah.
Even 7, 8 years, because that's probably what it's going to take, right? But who, you never know, things are moving so fast
right.
These days. But
I mean, for us, we want to build the CrowdStrike for social engineering, right? Again, there's no 800-pound gorilla yet. You know, you argue not even in security,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, right.
And you know, and especially in social engineering. So, you know, for us, we just, again, the data we collect makes us very unique. It gives us very unique AI applications, and that's how we just continuously add new products to our platform. So we've started off with what's traditionally been called digital risk. Executive protection has been one of our hottest in-demand products since the December incident, right, with United Healthcare, and then now we're even rolling out simulation products as well. So we just see a lot of opportunity in this particular space.
It's interesting you said CrowdStrike for social engineering. I have great admiration for CrowdStrike and George
Likewise.
Kurtz. They move fast.
They do.
Founder-led, hardcore. Low key in the sense that, you know, they're not, you know, chest thumpers.
Right.
They do some really good work. Explain your rationale with the CrowdStrike versus there are other companies that you could have aspired towards.
Yeah, well, look, I think what they do well, and you know, really what every great company does well is, I'd say two things, right? One, customer obsession, of course, is really critical, and you know, something I admire about Kurtz, right, is how much he's out there in the field, even to this day, right? Seeing customers, being there with customers, things like that, and so that's something that's very important here at Doppel. And then two is innovation, right? Like, how do you add something new for someone who's looking at buying a new vendor and providing value that they couldn't have before? And so we're a product-led company. Me and Rahul, our backgrounds are in the software engineering space, where, you know, not necessarily the traditional cybersecurity founders. And for us, that's what gets us excited every day, is to build new products and new capabilities that really solve customer pain points.
What's your go-to-market? Do you have relationships with other security firms, and you got some direct, some indirect. How do you go to market?
Yeah. So go to market, right? We've hired some great security go to market leadership, ex Okta, CrowdStrike, Tanium. You know, a lot of big companies, and for us, it's working closely with the ecosystem and the partner community, right? So we work very closely with the value added resellers. We find ways to partner with other vendors as well. And that's been critical for us is, security is an ecosystem and how do we play nicely in it.
So do you feel like you have product market fit?
Yes.
How do you know? How Andreessen says it's when your servers are blowing up.
Right.
I never really liked that answer. I'm like, all right, what if your servers aren't blowing up? Does that mean you can't have product market fit, or you just maybe have crappy go to market? And so, So how did you determine that you had product market fit? This is a really important question for a lot of entrepreneurs out there. Like, what were the signals that gave you confidence that you had product market fit?
Yeah, I think it's similar to the Andreessen answer, right? Which is like, you're getting so much demand now. And the key is repeatable demand as well, of course, right? Repeatable demand for the same sorts of products. And the battle that we have today at Doppel is how do we just scale faster, right? And so the meetings that we have today with the board are around, hey, we actually need to go even faster and even go more aggressive with our plans and grow the market team more, grow the engineering team more, and that's our top focus here at Doppel.
Interesting how you got here. Am I correct? This is your first CEO job?
Correct.
Okay, so awesome taking that on at such a young age. I love it. That's because you're fearless. So Uber and Lyft, so we've had Uber on. We love Uber. They're awesome.
Great team.
Kieran Midicetti, I don't know if you know that name.
Yes, of course.
And amazing. He's been on our show many, many times.
He's been one of my engineering mentors when I was an engineer.
They've done some really, really great work. And then you're an advisor for several years, 4 years, at Tola Capital. So you kind of learned, where to go, where not to go, and then jumped in. Really phenomenal story that you guys got going. I wish you the best and really appreciate you coming on. I hope you can come back and help us track your progress.
Absolutely. Well, I appreciate you having me on. Really enjoyed this conversation. And yeah, looking forward to next time, Dave.
You bet. Thanks, Kevin. All right, and thank you for watching. This is Dave Vellante for John Furrier and theCUBE, plus NYSE Wired, our Mixture of Experts series here at our NYSE studio. We'll be right back right after this short break.